talk to students about college readiness, get the lowdown on hypothermia, and check out the band concert, all on this week's episode of Laker Nation. Hello, and welcome to this week's episode of Laker Nation. I'm your host, Shelby Kocher. We start by congratulating the HLWW Ties Exceptional Teachers Award winners, Carol Meyerson and Jesse Robertson. Last week, Nate took to the campus and talked with students about college preparedness.
University of South Dakota or North Dakota or St. Cloud State. And yeah, that's all the ideas I have.
Do you know what you want to major in?
I do not yet.
Actually, I've already enlisted into the U.S. Army, so I don't have post-secondary plans at the moment.
Do you know what you want to do after the Army?
Actually, yes. Human resource manager.
I do. I plan on going post-secondary next year to Ridgewater, and then I'll go to Mankato after that.
What do you want to major in?
Elementary education.
I plan to attend the University of Wisconsin River Falls and major in agriculture education.
Yeah, I plan on going to Ridgewater for 2 years. And then wherever the wind takes me.
Well, what do you plan to major in?
Elementary education.
I haven't gotten accepted yet.
Where do you want to go?
I would like to go to UW La Crosse.
What do you plan to major in?
Business management. I'm going for cosmetology, Regency at Minnetonka.
I plan on going to Lake Region State College in Devils Lake, North Dakota, and pursuing simulator maintenance.
I'm going to major in sociology. I'm looking at, right now, 3 different colleges, so I'm not sure. I'll probably join the ROTC program. I applied for their scholarship, and after I'm done with college, I'll join the military as a second lieutenant.
I'm going to go to the University of Minnesota in Mankato for dental to be a dental hygienist.
My sister's moving up to Duluth, so I might be going to live with her while going to UMD, and if I get accepted, and I think that would be pretty cool.
What do you want to do up there?
Party.
I mean, like, major.
Like pre-med for nursing. Get my nursing license.
Okay. To go to UND.
What do you want to do there?
Aeronomics.
Aerodynamics. No, I get it. Yeah, planes and piloting. And Steven, what do you want to be when you grow up? Do you want to be another Monty?
No, I don't know yet, actually.
I'm going to go to Bemidji State University.
What are you going to major in there?
Music education.
Oh, like be a teacher?
Yeah.
Or a composer?
A teacher.
Going to Concordia University of Moorhead.
What are you going to major in?
Occupational therapy.
Yeah, I'm looking at the United States Military Academy. And then Crookston University, too, if I don't.
What do you want to major in there?
Aviation is what I plan.
Oh, that's nice, nice. Do you guys have any post-secondary plans?
No.
Say that again.
No.
Noah? I don't know.
I don't know, sorry.
Justin, do you have any post-secondary plans?
I'm going to go to Mankato.
What are you going to major in?
I don't know.
Just whatever.
I'd prefer if you stop touching me.
What do you plan to major in?
Maybe engineering, maybe computer science, I don't know.
Oh, something technical?
Yeah.
That's cool. Cool, yeah. Thanks.
Yeah, how about you? Do you have any post-secondary plans, Mr. Anchorman?
I want to go to either the University of Minneapolis or Mankato and become pre-med in psychology.
And a job in that field would be?
Psychiatrist.
There you go.
I would first take a personality test through Family Connection. I would then research what your dream job you think you might possibly want to do and contact those individuals and see what their line of progression was to get in the job that they wanted. Take the career and interest inventory survey on Family Connection.
Yes, I think that the first thing they have to do is they need to start thinking about it earlier on, talking to people, looking at different ideas, different careers, because it's a process. You can't just wake up one morning and say, oh, I want to be this. Decision making is a process, and the only way you can make a good decision is to gather a lot of information. So the problem is it takes a lot of time and energy and effort to do that, and the only students that are going to do that are the ones that are really worried about or thinking about their future. And that's really hard for students because most students are thinking about today more than they are their future.
We asked a lot of juniors and seniors mostly, but do you think sophomores should think about it the same way as juniors and seniors do?
The state of Minnesota now is saying that it really needs to start in sixth grade. And that's part of the problem is it's not talked about until they're juniors or seniors. And the reason we've done that in the past is because they don't care, even less. When they're in sixth grade and you're asking someone, what do you want to do after high school? It's like, I don't know. They could care less. By the time they get to 10th grade, it's still hard to get them to. But by juniors, you can get them to care a little bit more. But then it's almost too late because they've had all these years where they've had no instruction.
They're going to be talking to people that maybe work in a field that they want to go into, and then from there, find out what that's all about. Take a look, and the Navion system that we have right here is a great tool for the students to use, and that can give them some background information. Some of it's just getting out and experiencing things. So if they don't know what they're going to go into after high school, it's a lot of talk and it's a lot of getting out there and finding out what things are about. In college, I changed my major 5 times. So, and I never thought I'd be a principal, now here I am. But it's about experience, and it's about trying things and failing and moving on and allowing those doors to open up for you.
Thanks, Nate. This week in Laker News, the deadline for scheduled changes is December 19th. If you have any changes that need to be made, check in with the guidance office. NHS is hosting a toy drive December 1st through December 17th. Please bring in your new unwrapped toys to place in your class box. The winning class gets a donut breakfast. Just a reminder, turn in your overdue library books. The length of checkout time is 2 weeks. Thursday, December 11th, the Navy will visit the high school at 11:30 a.m. in the Commons. Friday, December 12th, Itasca Community College will be in the Media Center at 8:30. In sports, Tuesday, the 25th, the boys basketball lost to Watertown Mayor 38-55. Tuesday, the 2nd, boys basketball defeated Norwood 61-58, and girls basketball destroyed St. Cloud Cathedral 78-56, and gymnastics stomped Paintsville 114-108. In upcoming events, Monday, December 8th, girls basketball play Lester Prairie at home starting at 4:30. Also, Monday, the boys basketball travels to Mayor Lutheran, starts at 4:55. Tuesday, December 9th, girls 7th grade basketball faces Maple Lake at home at 3:45. Boys basketball hosts BBE. C-Squad is at the middle school at 6 p.m. JV and varsity start at 6 at the high school. Friday, December 12th, the girls 7th and 8th grade basketball versus Kimball at home in the middle school starting at 4:15. Girls basketball takes on Litchfield at home at 6 p.m. C-Squad plays in the middle school. Boys basketball travels to Maple Lake to take on the Irish starting at 6 p.m. Saturday, December 13th, boys basketball C-Squad goes to Glencoe for a tournament. The tournament starts at 9 a.m. Also at 9 a.m., the boys varsity wrestling invitational kicks off at Columbia Heights High School. Now that winter is in full stride, hypothermia can become a factor. Zach breaks it down to help us understand this deadly yet deceptive condition.
Hypothermia is caused by being in cold temperatures unprepared. Hypothermia can onset in as little as 20 minutes. Normally, muscles in the body keep it warm, and when faced with cold temperatures, the body attempts to regulate its temperature by shivering, which is the first symptom of hypothermia. One of the deadliest implications of hypothermia is when the body stops shivering. Other symptoms may include pale, cold skin, shallow or rapid breathing, slurred speech, exhaustion, confusion, loss of coordination, and in severe cases, unconsciousness. There are 3 major categories of hypothermia. Mild hypothermia is when the body temperature is between 95 and 90 degrees Fahrenheit. Normal human body temperature is 98.6. Moderate hypothermia onsets between 90 and 82 degrees, and a body temperature less than 82 can signify severe hypothermia. In the event someone is subject to hypothermia, one of the most important things to do is call for help. Also, remove their wet clothing and protect the person from the wind and the cold. Slowly rewarm the person, offer warm liquids, and take the person's temperature regularly.
Thanks, Zach. Last Thursday, the concert band performed their holiday concert. KLKR covered the event.
We filmed the HLWW annual holiday concert. I had the opportunity to interview some band players before it. Overall, it seemed Adventum was the crowd favorite, with Patapan as a close second. The concert kicked off with the HLWW jazz band, followed by a group of saxophones, which were followed by a brass group, and then a flute duet, all before the whole band played.
Probably like Adventum because it has lots of Christmas songs in it.
Nice. How do you think this year's band is going?
It's going pretty good. A little, some, it gets challenging at some point.
Nash, what are you playing in tonight's band?
Trumpet.
What are you playing, Nathaniel?
Oh, this is called the contrabass saxophone.
Truthfully, it's a baritone.
What is your favorite song in tonight's lineup?
You know, there's so many great ones, it's hard to choose.
How are you liking this year's band?
Oh, it's really great. It's awesome.
So, what are you guys playing tonight?
Okay, well, we're both percussionists, so.
Yeah, we play five songs, I think.
What are your favorite songs?
Mine is Adventum.
Yeah, like Christmas. Christmas music is a collaboration with, like, three different songs. All right, Nate, also my cameraman, what instrument are you playing tonight?
I play percussion and the trap set in jazz band.
What is your favorite song in tonight's lineup?
I'd say Pathfinder of Panama because I play the snare, and I like playing the snare.
How do you feel this year's band is
going? It's going good. We lost a lot of good people last year, but we have a bigger class since the ninth grade joined up, so we have a lot of fuller band this year.
Is this really weird that you're also my cameraman?
Yeah, because now there's no one behind the camera.
Thanks, Zach. That does it for this edition of Laker Nation. If you have any questions or show ideas, please contact us at our email, klkr@hlwwschools.org, and head over to our Facebook and YouTube channel and give us a like. See you next week.